in terms of connectivity, we have so much data coming in that we're gathering just by existing as a person. You know, we can walk around and now we have devices that track that. It tracks our heart rate, it tracks how many steps we've done, how many miles we go, how many flights of stairs we go up. But it can also track things like our weight at home and also if we've been taking medicine or not. There's a few applications out there. And the list goes on and on. I think that now we can understand what's going on with the patient outside of the traditional clinical setting. So, what's happening when they go home? What's happening when they go through life in general? So, we can understand how patients are experiencing their disease or condition through their everyday activities. And what's really fascinating is how do we extract meaningful insights from that where traditionally we haven't been able to. So we now are able to see data coming in almost instantaneously. And so, what does that mean for us in terms of our clinical opportunities? I think it's really a great time to be in. And there's a lot of frameworks that will be developed in the future. I see three main challenges with connected health today. The first is that we don't know if the data that's coming in is reliable and trusted. So, one of the largest strong points of a clinical trial is that we have control over how the data is being collected and we know the context of it. And I think that that presents the second biggest challenge is how do we assign context to the data that's coming in. So, what that means is if my, say, Fitbit tracker picks up that my heart rate is above a certain rate. Does it know that I'm exercising or does it think that I'm just sitting around and for some reason, because I have a medical condition, the heart rate jumps up? So I think that's one of the big challenges is assigning context to the situation. Another example that I can allude to is that, you know, if we're remotely tracking blood pressure, how do we know that that's clinically relevant for the patient or significant? So, for instance, some patients can experience blood pressure in different ways. So, if one patient is experiencing, say, a systolic blood pressure of 180, which is far above the range of normal, sometimes they're totally asymptomatic and it's not really affecting them. They don't have a headache or anything. But for other patients, if their blood pressure does pop up to that high of a range, they can actually experience stroke-like symptoms or sometimes even a stroke. So, one of the questions that we will have to address going forward is how do we assign context to the data that's coming in from connected devices? The third largest challenge is once this data comes in, is who is responsible for acting on the data? So, those are the large questions that we'll have to address going forward. There's ample opportunity for connections between academic partners and innovators making really great solutions on the ground. DCRI is an exciting place to do some of this groundbreaking research. I think we have a strong tradition in rolling out significant and relevant clinical trials that have led to guidelines in the past. And taking on from that experience, I think we would be a great partner for the new innovators coming out. So, providing both the clinical guidance but also the clinical trial piece to an area that has traditionally not prioritized research. So, digital tech. You know, in order to get adopted by a health system, by an insurance company, or by patients, you have to prove that a technology works. And not only do you have to prove that it works, but you have to run significant studies to show that these are actually true results and we can trust them. And so I think a partnership with DCRI pushes that needle forward.